In this video, we solve this rational equation. And when you eliminate the denominators, we get a quadratic equation and solve it. All right, we're going to solve this equation. And it's a rational equation because it contains fractions. So there's two methods for getting rid of the fractions, clearing the denominators. You can multiply both sides by the least common denominator, or you can write all the terms so that they all have the same denominator, and then that means the numerators will be equal. That's how I did it on problem one of this type. And that's going to take a lot less space. So that's how I'm going to do it. So I know I have a factor of 2x minus 5 and a factor of x plus 3. And what about this 2x squared plus x minus 15? Well, if you multiply these two factors together, you actually get 2x squared plus x minus 15. So this is really the same thing as 2x minus 5 times x plus 3. So the least common denominator is 2x minus 5 times x plus 3. So let's see if we could write everything with the same denominator. So this already has the least common denominator, so that's cool. We're all right here. All right, next term. On the right side of the equal side, I've got 5 over 2x minus 5, but I don't have my factor of x plus 3, so I need to multiply the top and bottom by x plus 3 to get the same denominator. And then over here we have x over x plus 3, and let's see, what do I need to multiply this by? The 2x minus 5. All right, now all the denominators are the same, which means the numerators are equal. If you don't believe that, the real reason it's true is because if you multiplied both sides by the least common denominator, it would simply cancel out every denominator and you'd be left again with the numerators. So they end up being equal. So what do I have here? In the numerator, I've got an 11, right? I've got a 5 times the x plus 3, and then I have a minus x times 2x minus 5. You got to be careful if there was something like an x plus 2 up here with a minus sign in front of it. You might want to distribute your minus sign first. Okay, so we've eliminated the fractions. So the next step is to do the distributive property here. So I have 11 equals, and we're going to distribute 5x plus 15 minus 2x squared. And remember, this is a minus x times a minus 5. That will be a plus 5x. Now just take a look at this for a minute. Notice we now have an x squared. We've got some x terms and some constants. We have a quadratic equation. So in a quadratic equation, we want to set the equation equal to 0. Let's just simplify one more step here by adding the 5x and the 5x. So we've got negative 2x squared plus 10x plus 15. And I want to set it equal to 0, and I have a negative 2x squared on the right side, so I always think it's easier when the a term is positive, although it's okay to just subtract 11 from both sides. In fact, just to be different, I'm going to do it that way. Let's subtract 11 from both sides. We have negative 2x squared plus 10x plus 4. If you would have put everything on the left-hand side, you would have 2x squared minus 10x minus 4. All your a's, b's, and c's would be opposite. And when you put it in the quadratic formula, you know what? You're still going to get the same values for your solutions. Okay, now we can go ahead and use the quadratic formula right here, but do you notice how there's a common factor of 2 or of negative 2 here? I'm going to go ahead and divide both sides by negative 2 so it's easier. So if I divide the left by negative 2 and every single term over here, then I've divided both sides of the equation by negative 2, I'm going to have easier numbers to plug in the quadratic formula. So I have 0 equals, hey, I made it positive after all, x squared minus 5x, and minus 2. Now, at this point, you would see if you could factor this, because it's a quadratic. But the only factors of 2 are 2 and 1, and there's no way you're going to get that negative 5 for your middle term. So we're going to use the quadratic formula. A is 1, B is negative 5, C is negative 2. By the way, if you wouldn't have divided by negative 2, you would have A is negative 2, B is 10, and C is 4. And you can verify that if you use those for your values of A, B, and C, when you're all done, in the end, you're going to get the same answer that I get when I use these values of A, B, and C. It's just that I'm going to have easier arithmetic. So let's do B squared minus 4AC. I like to do that first. So B squared will be 25 minus 4 times AC. 1 times negative 2 is negative 2. So I've got 25 plus 8, or 33. So that's what's going to go underneath the square root symbol in the quadratic formula. So you're ready for the quadratic formula? X equals negative b. B is negative 5. So negative b is going to be the opposite of that, or positive 5, plus or minus the square root of, there's your 33. That's what goes underneath the square root. 33 all over 2a. Alright, a is 1, so 2a is 2. And so those are my solutions. I have two of them. 5 plus square root of 33 over 2, and 5 minus square root of 33 over 2. And there we go. Let's go ahead and eliminate the fractions the traditional way by multiplying both sides of the equation by the least common denominator of 2x minus 5 times x plus 3. So I take my, you're going to see how it just is hard to get all on one page. I have 11 over, and I'm going to write that as 2x minus 5 times x plus 3. And you have to multiply that by 2x minus 5 times x plus 3, okay, and then that's going to be equal, now I've got the next term, 5 over 2x minus 5, and you're going to multiply that by 2x minus 5 times x plus 3 minus the last term on the right-hand side, and that also gets multiplied by 2x minus 5 times x plus 3. Okay, so in other words, you can see it takes two lines to get all this in here. But now let's do our canceling. This 2x minus 5's cancel, the x plus 3's cancel here, the 2x minus 5's cancel here, the x plus 3's cancel here. So what do I end up with? I've got the 11, it's hard to be careful, 11 equals, then I have 5 times x plus 3 minus x times 2x minus 5. So I have 11 equals 5x plus 15 minus 2x squared plus 5x. And that's exactly what we got before when we were eliminating the fractions by just making all the denominators the same. So this is the traditional way of doing it, but you sort of have to have a big piece of paper in order to write it all down, but it should lead you to the same basic equation. At this point, you would, you know, add like terms, set the equation equal to zero. You could divide again both sides by negative 2, like I did in the previous example, but the point is that is the same equation we had right here, right? So just alternate ways to eliminate the fractions, and that only works when you have an equation. When you're just adding fractions and you've got a denominator, you can't just make it disappear. You can't just eliminate it.